On weather-wise, it got the people moving around.
Yeah, and they're actually still driving through some low clouds and fog thanks to the all-day sea breeze keeping temperatures comfortably cool before they turn uncomfortably hot by the end of this holiday weekend. Right now, sunshine across the Golden Gate Bridge, but not exactly warm. West wind at 14, 57 degrees in San Francisco, so certainly jacket weather, not just for San Francisco, but into the North Bay, too. You see Tiburon there, sunshine and numbers in the upper 60s, southwest wind at 21 miles per hour, and even Livermore in the 60s right now, 68 degrees, wind coming in out of the west-northwest at 16. Could see temperatures anywhere from 20 to 25 degrees hotter by this time tomorrow out in the Tri-Valley and into San Jose. Another 60-degree reading here, 66 degrees, northwest wind at 13 miles per hour. So air quality-wise, there's enough wind tomorrow to keep things moderate for air quality for Sunday, but keep an eye on these AQI numbers for Monday. We'll see. We're going to get close to spare the air levels, I think, on Monday for your Memorial Day plans. Allergies. Still an issue out there. We haven't had a lot of rain to really kind of rinse some of the stuff out of the skies. Moderate, at least. It's not high anymore. Pine, oak, olive, cedar, and grass pollen. Still a pretty big lineup there in the allergy report. Sierra weather is interesting. Look at this. South of Highway 50 this afternoon, we're getting these thunderstorms firing up. That will start to weaken once the sun sets. So from thunderstorms in the Sierra to the drizzle storm that continues on the coast and all the fog you saw there along the San Mateo Bridge across the bay, you see it right there on the satellite for areas just basically south of the Bay Bridge, over the San Mateo Bridge, not quite to the Dumbarton Bridge. You still got the fog, and look at that, banked up along the Santa Cruz Mountains. Good, strong case of ocean air conditioning. That will begin to go away during the day tomorrow. So we wake up very similar to what we had this morning with more low clouds, a little bit of drizzle and fog on the coast, but unlike today, clearing skies. Even out near the coast, as temperatures really start to climb over the next couple of days. So patchy fog inland, some 40s and 50s to start the morning off. And then as we head towards the afternoon, take a look at the temperatures tomorrow. Upper 80s in San Jose, 90s south of downtown, Los Gatos, Saratoga, close to 90 degrees. Hottest places around the Bay Area tomorrow, Contra Costa County up to Solano County, where you'll see numbers in the mid to upper 90s tomorrow. Look at Oakland up to 80, 87 degrees in Fremont. Peninsula temperatures now into the 70s and 80s. So the temperatures on the peninsula tomorrow even hotter than the inland spots we had around the Bay Area today. Downtown San Francisco likely into the 70s, and up into the North Bay, numbers here starting to climb through the mid to upper 90s. So the heat setting up in the North Bay, and then by Memorial Day Monday, heat advisories up for the North Bay and East Bay valleys where we could climb above 100 degrees. Look at that, Concord, Livermore, Fairfield up to Santa Rosa, San Francisco near 80 degrees, 90 in Oakland. That's your Memorial Day Monday with these hot temperatures trending a little bit cooler Tuesday back into the low 90s inland as high pressure gives up some ground for the middle part of the week. You see how the high starts to weaken just a bit. Storm passing by to the north should trigger a stronger sea breeze, a little bit of cooling into Thursday and Friday. Then as we head towards next weekend, first weekend of June, just like that, the year just flies on by. High pressure building back, so we could see another warming trend setting up for next weekend. So take a close look. These are San Francisco temperatures. Monday, obviously the hottest day, could be near records on Monday around the bay as we got 80s and 90s bayside, upper 90s to near 100 degree temperatures inland on Monday, then trending cooler, really kind of a 2 to 3 day heat spell before things cool down for the second half of the week. But boy, hot finish to Memorial Day weekend plans around the Bay Area. Those temperatures climbing well through the 90s inland for Monday. Back to you.
Record heat coming here as we're wrapping up May. What is this? Does anybody looking at the long range here? Is this believed to be an especially hot summer around here? I know that it's not something you do every weekend, but some people do look ahead. Mm-hmm. It looks especially hot.
Yeah, we were lucky. I think in the last 2 weeks, we've had the strong ocean air conditioning, the deep marine layer and morning mist and drizzle. What's interesting is looking at next weekend, that high that tries to build back next weekend, it does look hotter and drier than average, even by June standards, long range forecast through the middle of June. So a sign of things to come, I think, over the next 2 weeks.
Wow. All right, Rob.
It's going to be a hot summer.
Yeah.
Rob, thank you.